It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports. And coming up, it'll be no holds barred between AFC South rivals. It's the Houston Texans and the Indianapolis Colts. And it's coming up next.
Just a stone's throw from historic Monument Circle in downtown Indianapolis, we are at the beautiful Lucas Oil Stadium. Today, it's an intra-division matchup in the AFC South, as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Indianapolis Colts. Here's the punter, Rigoberto Sanchez, on to get us started. And we are underway from Indianapolis. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. Leading them out, a two-year starter at Ohio State and second overall pick in the draft, C.J. Stroud.
I tell you what, when he's on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. And a good physical run that time. He's going to wind up gaining 5 on that one.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Second and 5. Back to throw. Here's Stroud. Open man is Noah Brown, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
They'll run it for the first time with Damian Pierce. Yeah, boy, and it's tough to bring him down that time. He surges forward. He's going to get a full 6 out of that. Second down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Ball on the 39. Here's second and 4. Now Stroud. Right side complete. That's Woods. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Stroud to throw it. That's complete. It's Collins. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
Stroud. Over the middle, complete. That's Brown. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Well, they clearly wanted to come out, Charles, and be aggressive throwing the football, and they've been pretty efficient along with that aggressiveness. He's now 4-for-4 on this opening drive.
Yeah, and that's led to a fresh set of downs. I like what he's doing back there. You can tell he's at ease, feels good about what he's doing. I think if I'm the play caller, I'm reading that, I'm continuing to let him throw the football.
And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. DeForest Buckner using that size to force his way in there and make the stop behind the line.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
Stroud on third down now. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Dalton Schultz, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Texans will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. They gotta love that. 9-play drive results in 6 points.
That means they're doing the dictating. That means that they've described how the game's going to go. They're playing at their tempo, at their pace. If you're on the other side of the ball, if you're playing defense, defense is not methodical. They've got to go in there and shake things up and create a little havoc.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. Leading them out, still one of the most recognizable QBs in the game and one of the most fun QBs in his fifth season. It's Gardner Minshew.
And how about this young man? Took the NFL world by storm as a 6th-round rookie, signature mullet, mustache, but 21 touchdowns for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Great personality, and everyone gravitates towards this guy. Teammates love to win with a quarterback who leads them like that, and fans love to root for a guy who seems just like them.
Off play action, it's Minshew. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you've got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 44-yard line. On the counter, it's Taylor. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And they'll come up second and 7.
Looking to throw it, Minshew. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Minshew sets to throw. A connecting here with Pittman on the out route. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Interesting decision here. Opening drive, Charles, fourth and short. You're in field goal range. We'll see what they do.
I just shake a fist at my offense and say, go get it, guys, because if you can't pick up fourth and short here, we're probably in trouble the rest of the game. Show some confidence. Show some aggressiveness. Go pick it up.
And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And this Texans defense stands tall. So their first drive of the game already trailing, having given up points. A little surprised that they went for it, right?
Maybe the big guy, the head coach, senses this is going to be a shootout type of a game, that they've got to match them point for point, as opposed to, hey, we'll get them later. Maybe he just has that sense, and that's why he decided to go for it there.
Good starting field position for the Houston Texans here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Singletary to get the drive started. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
If you're in the offensive huddle, you're smiling after that play because you've certainly got them guessing now. Second and short, could they just hand it off for another big gain, or did they take advantage of this spot to take a big shot downfield?
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Texans football to start quarter 2. As they've got it with a second and 4 coming up. As Stroud now to throw. It's complete to Brown, right side. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down. Stroud looking to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Collins. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An out cut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
A shotgun snap to Stroud. Quick slant to Brown. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 35. 11 yards there as they connect on the quick slant.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Again, it's Stroud. This will be caught once again by Brown. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
2 minutes gone by, second quarter. On second down, here's a run with Singletary. Hard running at the 15. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. The broken tackle could not free him as he's brought down at the 10-yard line.
credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Now a toss to Singletary running to the left. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. He couldn't get the edge there. It wasn't sealed, so maybe not all on the guy running the football all the time on those tosses and the pitches that go to the outside.
No, not at all. I would agree with that totally, because sometimes the defensive guys, they win the edge battle. And when they do that, there's no place for the running back to go.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Dalton Schultz. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Texans have taken a two-touchdown lead now. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
You throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. That time, a nine-play drive. And it was the tight end Dalton Schultz on the touchdown reception to cap the drive. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. That one finds Pierce right side. And that's good for a gain of six, and it's second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
From the 29, here's a second and four. From the gun, it's Taylor, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance. Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
On fourth down, the Colts will call on Rigoberto Sanchez for the punt. Desmond King deep for Houston. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. 36 yards on the punt with no return. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. C.J. Stroud and the offense back out there. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game,
The alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Play action. Here's Stroud. He's got it to Collins, complete. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there, as that will lead us right into the two-minute warning. On first down, here's Stroud. Got a man. It's Collins, complete.
And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Here goes Stroud again.
Now they go screen. It's complete. No gain on the screen there at second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Second and 10. Here's Stroud.
He finds his target. It's Schultz. Even with that broken tackle, he'll be brought down short of the 15. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Robert Woods. A 16-yard touchdown.
And the Texans will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Well, to put it mildly, he's been able to dice up this secondary all game long. And this time, that was a missile that he threw into the end zone and adding another touchdown to his ledger.
And I think we see these youngsters develop a lot quicker than we ever have, because when they get started in this game, they're not just throwing passes around. They're reading coverages early. So now they're like seasoned pros earlier in their career. How about this one here? If they win this ball game, a game ball definitely coming from his head coach.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. And the Colts about to go on offense one final time in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. Now Minshew. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Well, he certainly didn't like what he saw at all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to his safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage was in lockdown mode everywhere.
Here's second and 10.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right.
Now here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give to Taylor.
Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts
as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Minshew, first and 10. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Throw now on the final play. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. This was an extremely one-sided first half. One team showed up, ready to go. The other's been in a daze thus far, but there's still plenty of time left for this one to tighten up significantly.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Colts getting the football first, and they trail here as we are back underway in quarter number three. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. The Colts going to take over on offense to begin this third quarter. Well, they look up at the scoreboard facing that deficit. A three-score game, Charles, but look, there's plenty of time to go here. The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though, out of this drive, at least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no three-score drive on that play sheet for any of those coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive, but maybe cut into it a little bit as you just suggested. Try and create a little bit of momentum, a little bit of a spark, and then maybe that'll carry over. Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about 6.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
From the 48-yard line, here's a second down and 4. Minshew going to try and run. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so they didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
Here's Minshew. Oh, had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
Just more frustration here offensively, and you can see it in their play and now in their body language. You know they were hoping to put a drive together to begin this third quarter, but it's just not clicking right now, and it's going to be a quick call to the punt team.
Sanchez on to punt here as he sends this one away.
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Here's the Texans offense now, readying for their first possession of the second half.
Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
On second down, it's Stroud. He'll complete this one to Collins.
And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Singletary trying the left side, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
No doubt about it, a really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Stroud out of the gun here. He finds his man complete. That's Schultz. It'll go as a gain of 4. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Here is 3rd and 5. Now Stroud.
Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. First target, first catch, and a first down.
They brought in the heavy set on 3rd down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation, and sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a 1st down.
Stroud to the air on 1st and 10.
And Woods has it complete, and he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The 2nd down throw now from Stroud.
He finds his man complete. That's Beck. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it, but he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers, neither side looks on track in the ground game. Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds.
The Colts getting another possession here on offense. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast.
In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Minshew and the Colts going to come up here first and 10.
Just shy of the 30. Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
And right about now, you start to think, and maybe they're starting to think, gosh, maybe points aren't going to happen for us in this game.
Well, it's a thought that is worth having because so far in this game, this defense has not just had the upper hand. They've appeared to be a step ahead, maybe even two steps, to everything they've done. They've had an answer for everything this offense has thrown at them.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Throwing now is Stroud.
Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second.
No question, that was needed by the defense because they're already trailing by a couple of scores. They had to get off the field without allowing another one. That sack on the first play, that may have derailed this drive.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Stroud. Over the middle, he gets it to Collins. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Now here's Stroud. Throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
The kick by Fairbairn is good. And the route is on. It's 24 to nothing. Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The Colts set to take over here offensively. And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
You're exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play, multiple plays, that puts the ball in the air and allows for them to have some success.
No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Looking to throw it, Minshew. Throw out right, pulled in by Downs. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. We have played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. Minshew sets to throw. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And that is incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's got a man complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
Well, give them credit. They're going to stay and fight this out to the end. Fourth down, you've got to go for it. And they not only convert, but pick up some good yardage as well.
It'll be Minshew again. That's caught by his tight end, Kylan Granson. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second down and a little more than a yard here. They'll look to throw again. Finds his big tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 18. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. What a game this defense continues to play, huh?
Yeah, they've been aggressive from the first snap, and they've controlled this ball game. But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you've got to match that aggressiveness. No points so far in this game. Moving the football, got to be that way to go against them and try and get some points on the board.
And I'm curious on the defensive side, if they stay aggressive, because you know they want to pitch this shutout.
Yeah, they have to be aggressive, but they also have to be smart about it as well, because one mistake can turn into 6 points.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. They'll look to throw here. Toward the pylon, caught. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
The defense was ready for the back to leak out and even had a second player waiting to double him up. If you're going to commit to doubling a back, you better prevent a completion, but give him credit. Extra determination, extra effort, turned it into a successful play.
Taylor is going to take this one in for a Colts touchdown. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. 3 downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
And now the Colts are going to keep the offense on the field as they'll go for 2 here. And Minshew will throw for it. And this one incomplete. So they went for the 2. They don't get it. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. Sheds off the tackle, and the effort snuffed out. The Texans' hands team recovers. Well, CD, you understand. I mean, they're so eager trying to get back in this game here the fourth quarter, but they touched that one a little too early before it went 10 yards.
Brandon, in such a high-stakes scenario, everyone's feeling the pressure on this play. The special teams coordinator, which one is he going to pick in terms of kicks? Can the kicker execute it? Can the team wait for 10 yards? So many variables, and in this case, they didn't get it done.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Singletary, they'll go up the middle, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Singletary again. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. 54 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Well, I don't think there's any question, Brandon, at this stage. The stop troops, the defensive guys, they've got to use their three timeouts here. They've got to stop them and get the ball back.
Yeah, if you're in that 2-3 score deficit window that they're in now, you got to get it ASAP.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Stop them, use your timeouts. Easier to move the ball on offense without timeouts than to stop them on defense without using them.
They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Now, that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Here's 2nd and 3. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a 1st and goal. Hate to be blunt, but it is just continuing to prove to be the case that this O-line is manhandling this D-line right now.
They deserve to roll up their sleeves and show up their biceps because they're doing exactly what you just described, manhandling the defensive front. They've got the leverage, they are powering through, and they're controlling this game.
So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They've got it 1st and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
In most goal line situations, defensive tackles are just trying to hold the line, hold their ground, and let the other guys roam and make the play. But in this situation, he's able to push his way into the backfield and disrupt that play for a loss.
On the give, this is Singletary. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
3rd and goal, Stroud. Touchdown! Nico Collins, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Texans are able to widen their advantage. Another touchdown through the air for them, and for this rookie quarterback at the helm, he has put them in a great position, Charles, to get the victory in this one.
He's absolutely taken charge. Every touchdown for them has come via his arm. 0 rushing touchdowns, no special teams, no defensive scores. All him throwing the football, he's in cruise control right now, and so is his team.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And they open the lead up now to 25. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD, but unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
Now Minshew on first and 10. He's got the tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Throwing on second down now, Minshew. That's going to be, and now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. And now this ball picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself. Throwing on first down is Minshew. A short one there, caught by Granson. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days, but you can flex him.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Third and 5. Now Minshew. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
One last shot at the end zone. Oh, and that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this Texans defense stands tall. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. So Houston going to come away here with the victory. And I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done. Really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball. You're handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls plural.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
I
like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent, yeah, like the best player of all, yeah, of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people.